Hi there, guys. So today I got to do something that I never thought would ever happen, and that is I got to see Gerard Way and I got to meet Mikey Way. And of course, me being me, I decided I had to vlog the whole experience, and so I did. And that is my last video, so be sure to check that out if you haven't already. Yes, I'll start on Monday. Last Monday was my first day back to school since I had a spring break, and during my spring break I made a lot of videos, and so I didn't have a lot of real free time because I was working on videos and filming videos and making sure I was getting everything up. And that Monday when I had gone back to school, I was really, really emotional about the whole thing, and I really, really didn't want to go on, I didn't want to continue, and I was just done with everything because I didn't have any chance to relax. Just to make a long story short, it was just a really awful day. And I remember that night, my dad came up and reassured me, and he said, "It's okay." He gave me a hug and he said, "Good things are coming." And the very next day, my dad surprised me and told me that we were gonna go to WonderCon to go see Gerard Way. The way he showed me though was really cool, and I'm not gonna forget it anytime soon. He showed it to me and he said, "Look, he's gonna be at WonderCon this year." And I said, "Oh yeah, that's cool." Honestly, I had completely oblivious about what was gonna happen then, right then and there. And he had just kind of mentioned, he said, "Oh yeah, well, it's too bad because all the tickets for Saturday sold out, and you know, we're gonna be busy on Sunday." And I'm like, oh well. Then he handed me my ticket and he said, "Surprise, you're gonna go on Friday." And I was so, so happy that joy had carried on into the next couple of days leading up to today. And today, I honestly didn't think it was possible to be this happy. We got to the convention and we waited in line for what felt like an absurd amount of time. And because the line was so long, it had taken a long time to get our badges, which you have to wear at all times so they know that you've actually like paid for the event. So we ended up being late to the young animal panel, and when I had first went in, I had my camera in hand and they told me that I wasn't allowed to film, and so I had to put it away. But when I first walked in, I made direct eye contact with Gerard. And at that moment, I felt like I was gonna have a heart attack. So we just walked over to a row on the side, which we were closest to, and we sat down. And I really, really wanted to record, but I was actually considering maybe breaking the rules, which is very out of character for me, if you know me. I didn't, of course, but I was tempted to. They had talked about, when we had first gotten there, it was about the future of Cape Carson, which I am reading. I haven't been up to date with it, though. They also talked about Shade the Changing Girl, and they talked very briefly on Doom Patrol. I assume that at the time that we got there, they had already finished talking about Doom Patrol, which is kind of sad because I wanted to know what was, you know, kind of going to happen next. And they showed previews for a new part of the imprint that's coming out, which is called Bug something. I already forgot the name. I'm not entirely sure on who's writing it, but it seems like an interesting story. When it got towards the end, they opened up the area to where you could ask them questions, which was just a microphone on a stand. And they had said, if anyone wants to ask a question, just feel free to go up. And people were lining up to the microphone. I had kind of just let my eyes follow them, and in my peripheral vision, I saw a man who looked a lot like Mikey Way. And I thought, oh, that's not him. for a second. I thought I just kind of was imagining it. But upon thinking that I saw him, I decided to look fully behind me. And I saw him sitting right next to his wife, Kristen. And immediately, I brought my head back and leaned over to my dad and said, "Oh my God, Mikey and Kristen are right behind us." And my dad kind of laughed at me and he said, "Oh, ask him for a picture." And I'm like, okay, I will. My dad encouraged me to go ask a question. And I couldn't think of anything until there was already too many people in the line. And then I thought, I have the perfect idea. It would be a question for everybody, that what is your advice for amateur comic writers who maybe have limited resources? And so I quickly got up and ran over to the line. And when I got to the line, one of the guy who works there, he looked at me and he says, "Sorry, just gonna let you know, they're probably not gonna be able to get to your question, but you can still stand in line if you want." And so I was like, "Yeah, I'm still gonna stand in line." So I stood there, not even like 30 seconds longer. They had taken too long on the second question they had been asked, and they were trying to get them to hurry up. And so they had said, "Oh, okay, well, they're telling us to hurry, so we'll just answer one more question." And that kind of just discouraged everyone, and they all left the line. And I didn't want to be that weirdo who still stood in the line even when everyone else had left. Gosh, I wish I had stayed. They probably would have gotten to my question. Probably would have had enough time to just squeeze in me. I don't know. Maybe not. Maybe I'm just overthinking it all. And then, not too long after, the whole thing ended. And immediately after, I had just kind of turned around to Mikey, and he was, like, mumbling. I couldn't tell if he was actually, like, talking to his wife or not, or maybe he was just kind of mumbling something to himself. He was probably talking to his wife, because, yeah, he was talking clearly in the beginning, but when I had turned around, he was just kind of mumbling. And I kind of interrupted him now that I realize it. I just said, "Excuse me, Mikey?" And he looked straight up at me. And he looked at me in a way that just, like, completely warms my heart when I remember how the whole thing happened. He was just kind of looking off to the side, and I said, "Mikey?" And he looked up, and it's like his, like, eyes brightened, and he was like, "Yeah?" Like, "Yeah, that's me." I just told him that I can't thank you enough for the ways that you have helped me and how you have inspired me, and thank you for just the music that you have created, and it really means a lot to me. Well, I mean, that's what I had intended to say, but that's not what I said at all. I ended up saying, "Mikey, do you think I could get a picture with you?" But seriously though, even though I didn't get to say what I wanted to say, he was still super sweet and super kind. And he was just looking at me the whole time, and he smiled and he said, yeah, of course. And he looked so happy about the whole thing. And he stood up and started walking towards my chair where I was at. And I stood up and walked around, and then he kind of stopped for a moment, and my dad said, "Go over to where he is." And then I started going over, and then he would stop, and it was just this weird, like, we didn't know where to go for a second. And then he just says, "Don't worry, I'll come to you." And he walks around fully over to my area. And my dad has his phone out and everything, and I just stood there and I looked up at him. I always thought that Mikey was super tall, but he surprisingly wasn't as tall as I had imagined. I'm pretty sure he's 5'11". And for some reason I imagine 5'11 being a lot taller than it actually is. But he surprisingly was only a little bit taller than my dad. He had first, like, moved over to me and looked at me. He gave me the most heartwarming smile. And when I think about it, I feel like bubbles. I feel butterflies when I think about it. He just looked at me and he gave me such a sweet smile. He looked down at me, he just gave me such a nice, caring smile, and I can't stop saying that, oh my gosh. And then he put his arm around me and he kind of pulled me a little bit closer to him than I already was, which surprisingly, which we didn't need. We were already fairly close, and then he decided to pull me in even closer. This is probably gonna sound weird, but he was so soft. He was so, like, soft and cuddly, and I was... That was something that I never, ever, ever would have imagined. He was wearing a jacket that was really soft as well, and I had put my arm around him as he's mirroring what he had done, and just like having, just feeling like a whole, from like the moment he put his arm around me, I didn't want him to ever take it away. And that sounds so like such a fangirl, crazy, obsessed thing to say, and I realized that, but it was just so calming, and honestly, I don't think I'm ever gonna get over how nice he was to me. Because people talk so much about how celebrities will put on an act, and they'll talk about how they're really just nice in interviews or to certain fans when it's being broadcasted. But he was so nice and caring towards me, and he just had so much like excitement and happiness in his face, and this is probably the highlight of my entire year so far. And I know it's early in the year, but I'm just gonna call it right now. This is probably the best thing that's ever happened to me so far in this entire year, and without a doubt is the best thing that has ever happened to me since last year. He was also really nice to my dad too. I think I might have caused a bit of commotion because right after I had gotten a picture with him, a few other people came. I took one of the pictures for this one girl. She was dressed in a revenge era costume, and she had come over and she asked me to take the photo for her, and I did what I thought she probably would have wanted. And when I held up the camera and I held it in frame, I just rapidly pressed the pressed the button to take pictures. So I tried to get as many pictures as I could, because that's what I would have wanted if someone was taking a picture. I'm actually really not that good when it comes to photos, and so I really, really hope that she got a good photo. Thankfully, I held it all together as I was in front of Mikey and Kristen. I wanted to say hello to Kristen. I wanted to take a picture with her as well, but I'm not so sure if she wanted to. She was just kind of looking at her phone, kind of not so much disinterested, but just kind of like, oh yeah, he'll do his thing. I'll just be here. But she seems like an absolutely lovely person. Also, I heard a lot of rumors that she was faking her pregnancy, and I honestly don't know why. I think she's even mentioned them before, that she's like, no, that's BS, I'm totally, why would I fake being pregnant? She has said that, but I am her witness. I have seen her. She's not faking it. You can get on me, Kristen, don't worry, I got your back. So anyways, after the whole ordeal, I had thankfully kept it together and not cried in front of them. I of course ended up crying later, but thankfully it was not in front of them. So yeah, that was how it all happened. That's how I met Mikey Way. And then I ended up stalking his brother for the next like 2 hours. Okay, when I say this, like, I actually kind of feel bad. I thought the whole thing, because I was following him, I was actually following his every move, trying to get him on camera at all times and trying to say hello to him. And I think he realized that, because the first time we made eye contact was when I first went to the panel and I walked in and he directly looked at me, and I was like, and from then on throughout the panel, he also made eye contact with me, just a couple of glimpses, some of them longer than others. Some of them I couldn't tell if he was actually looking at me or not. Then we went out to like the DC like booth area, I guess you can call it a panel, I don't know what you would call it. There was people signing who were from the animated Teen Titans Go series, and so we're like, okay, he's not here yet. So we didn't wait. We ended up walking around a little bit, seeing some other stuff, and then we're like, okay, let's go back to see if he's there. So we walked back, and sure enough, he was there, and I got an even closer look at him this time. And if you saw my vlog, you saw that I moved around quite a bit. I was in the same area for a long time, trying to get the best possible shots I could of him, and trying to get close enough to a point where I could say hi to him. We just went around the whole area, and they were passing out, the people around there were passing out a bunch of free comics and posters, and we got a ton of them because my dad told me, if someone gives you a free sample for something, take it. Even if you already have it, take it. Take as many as you can. And so, following my dad's orders, I said yes to absolutely everything, and this isn't even like a quarter of the things that we got for free. This was the one that we got right as we had gotten our badges, which everyone is kind of supposed to take because it shows you where everything is and what times certain things are happening, so yeah, this is important. And this one shows you all the people who are going to be there on this day, and look! Tori's there! Look, it's the same photo! They also gave us a ton of posters, which I was more than happy to take. I haven't opened any of these, I don't know what they look like. I'm near positive I already know what they look like, but this is the Doom Patrol one. The world's strangest heroes return, the Doom Patrol, they're back! Beginning September 2016, I remember that, that was a good time to be alive. Next is Shade the Changing Girl, which I already know this one. This is just the cover for the very first one. Then we have Mother Panic, so we meet Violet Page, Celebrity by Day, and Gotham City's Brutal Vigilante by Night, Mother Panic. And last but not least, out of all the young animal posters we got, was Kate Carson Has a Cybernetic Eye. Following the others is also just a poster of the very first issue, okay? A psychedelic adventure below the earth, through the mind, and beyond reality. So anyways, after we got a crap ton of posters and stuff, we had walked around and I tried to take some photos with Gerard. It was kind of just Gerard in the background. The best one was one of him drinking coffee. I know, totally iconic Gerard drinking coffee. That's probably the best one because it actually kind of looks like he's looking at the camera, which, now that I think about it, he might actually be looking at the camera, and I honestly don't really know anymore. And then we saw that he was getting up, and I thought, oh, he's probably just taking a break, he's probably not done with the whole thing, and he got up and left. He was walking directly towards me, and I just kind of froze for a second. He was looking kind of in the same direction that I was in, because he was right in front of me, but it felt like he was kind of purposefully not trying to look at me, because I think he knew if he looked right at me and or said hi to me or something, that I would want to start talking to him and to try and get a photo or whatever. As he was getting closer, I finally kind of felt a little bit of confidence. And it wasn't so much confidence, but a feeling that if you don't do it now, you're probably never going to be able to. And so I just was like, hi! Hi there! Hi, Gerard! And he kind of glanced in my area, and he just smiled. He didn't wave, he didn't say hi back, because like I said, I think he probably knew what that would lead to, and he just wanted to have a break. He just kind of faint little smile and kept on walking. I wanted to follow him, but I was like, oh, I don't know, I probably shouldn't. And then I was like, well, my dad was like, come on, we need to go follow him, basically. And so I was like, okay. But I thought a lot of people were actually also following him, so I was like, it's not totally weird, multiple people are following him. But then I found out that it just so happened they were going the exact same way as him, and then I felt like a total stalker. But then he went out to like this patio area on the next level. And he went to go take a cigarette break. And I was honestly kind of shocked when I saw him take out a cigarette, because I was like, oh, I legitimately thought he quit. I don't know what it was that was in me that made me think that, because he never said that he did. But for some reason, I just assumed that he did. I didn't record that part at all, though, because I was like, he clearly just wants space. I'm not gonna record. I'm not gonna go out there and talk to him. I'm just gonna let him, you know, be alone. And then eventually, he came out, and right then and there, I had felt like a surge of confidence, and I planned to go up to him, and I was right as he was walking away, because he was fairly close to me, and I was gonna go up and say, "Excuse me, hi, can I get a photo with you, please?" And I was totally gonna do that, and I felt it. I saw him coming towards the door, and I was like, "Yes, I'm gonna do it, I'm gonna meet him." And then all of a sudden, I saw him, and I saw how close he was, and I thought, "Oh crap, I can't do this." All of a sudden, it was just all that confidence that I had built up completely drained, and I couldn't even get up out of my chair. I was like too nervous about the whole thing. Then he went over to this area which he was getting interviews from, and multiple people, when they were like taking breaks in between interviews and stuff, would come up to him and ask for pictures, and he did a couple of them, and then this one girl came up and got his autograph and a picture, and I was like, cool, he's doing that, I'm gonna go up next, I'm going to do it. And then I'm actually gonna do this. And so I started walking towards him a little bit closer than I already was, and then one of the interviewers starts talking to him, and it was like my heart just shattered. I was like, no, I waited all this time, and I'm not gonna be able to. Because I wasn't just gonna straight up go and say, "Oh no, excuse me, I need to say hello to this man." Because the guy had been waiting the whole time, and I apparently, he might have not seen me or whatever, or maybe he just honestly didn't give a crap. And that's when we tried to take more pictures with him that went about the same way as the first ones did when he was actually doing the autographs. He'd be like, "All right, bye." And then the interviewer would leave, and I would walk towards him. So I'm like, okay, now is my chance. And then right as I would be walking towards him, another interviewer would come and sit down and immediately start talking. And that happened at least 3 times. And so we figured, okay, how about we go just walk around, look at other stuff for a little bit, and then come back and see. And when we came back, he had already left. The fact that I got to see him, that he made eye contact with me, that I got to meet his brother, it was just such a nice experience, and it's so much more than the average fan would get to do. And just the fact that I have been able to do as much that I have is enough. I wasn't really planning on doing this, but yesterday, on the 30th, I decided to write what I was going to be doing today in my journal, and I feel it. I should read it aloud. I can't believe this is happening. Tomorrow I'm going to see my hero. 2 days ago, my parents surprised me by buying me a ticket to WonderCon so I can go see Gerard Way. Ever since I found out I was going, I've been incredibly excited. It isn't very likely that I'll be able to meet him, but I fantasize about it constantly. I really want to hug him. I want to thank him for all the ways he has helped me. I want to get his autograph and put it in a frame so I can cherish it forever. I have a feeling that tomorrow just might be the best day of my life. 3/31/17. Out of the 15 years that I've been alive, today has probably been one of the greatest I've ever experienced. I went to the convention hoping to get the attention from Gerard, but ended up getting it from his brother instead. Mikey was so kind and caring, and he smiled at me in a way that just warms my heart just at the thought. Thank you, Gerard and Mikey, for how you have inspired me, and for the joy you have brought into my life. This whole ordeal has made me realize how fortunate I am. It has helped me recognize how incredibly blessed I am. So many people would kill just to be in the same room as them, and I don't want to take any of this for granted. Thank you to my parents, who have set this all up for me. Through this, you have made me incredibly happy, and I love you more than words can explain. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed it, and please be sure to check out my last video if you haven't already. Alright, I'll see you in the next video. Bye. You know what I just realized? Is that Mikey touched this jacket. He touched it right here along the back. I don't think I'm ever gonna wash this jacket ever again.